Hi, I'm Kaitlin Milliken from Innovation Leader, and I'm here with my colleague Scott Kirsner to talk about our latest research, developing innovation metrics and reports that really matter. Scott, how are teams at big companies measuring innovation?
Largely, they're not doing it very well yet. When we conducted the survey that's in this report, we found that more than half of companies say that their innovation metrics are non-existent or they're still taking shape. So we put together this report to try to address that. We found that there's basically two kinds of metrics. There's activity metrics, which show that you're busy doing stuff. Maybe you're building prototypes, or you're interviewing customers, or you're taking meetings with relevant startups or collecting ideas. But at some point, you also need to start gathering impact metrics, which show that all that activity is having an impact on the business. And impact metrics are things like net promoter score. You know, do customers really like what you're doing? And do they like a new product or service? Things like cost savings and efficiencies. And the top metric that people are really looking for is revenue generated. Are you creating things that are productive and positive and profitable for the business to be doing?
We talked to a number of innovators at large organizations to find out what they're specifically measuring. That included Dana Naberezny, who runs the Jewelry Design and Innovation Workshop at Tiffany and Company. Dana says her team looks at first pass yield, which compares the number of ideas at the front end of the design process to those that make it into Tiffany stores.
We look at what we call our first pass yield, which is a really common measurement that people use all the time in manufacturing facilities and production. But we look at it not just as a measure of production, but we also look at it as a measure of how we've done in the upfront part of the development process. So have we given the right specifications? Is our CAD design on point? The prototypes that we've created, all of those things, it's important for us to look and understand the influence of what we've created at the front part of the process as the product starts continuing through that overall development process.
If you're not yet a member of Innovation Leader, you can get an excerpt of the report at innovationleader.com/research. If you are a member, you can get the full 45-slide deck on innovation metrics and reporting right now. I want to thank you for watching this video, and I want to thank our friends at Planbox for helping support this research initiative.